Middle 1950s, intensive rearing of poultry began. It was not uncommon for farmers to lose 40, 60, 80% of their birds to Merrick's disease.
Think a little bit of it like cancer for chickens. When you see 20 to 80,000 animals go down, it's heartbreaking.
And there was no cure.
One of the worst diseases any species can have. It was a major problem. People didn't know what to do. It is a virus that transmits very well through the environment. It can affect your brain, blood vessels. It can produce your tumors. So it's going to kill the birds no matter what. You cannot grow a flock if you don't have Marek's disease under control.
The cause of Marek's disease was discovered in 1967. A vaccine was developed. But there are some issues that remained. At that time, they were vaccinating in the neck area. Chickens were then let loose, and they were immediately exposed to virulent Marek's disease. The idea occurred that could we give the vaccine time to initiate immunity before chickens hatch? Inoval vaccination is the immunization of chickens by injecting the vaccine in the egg before hatch. When they were exposed to Marek's disease, they were fully protected. And that was a result beyond anybody's expectations. As you would expect, there was a lot of skepticism. I did not find much acceptance. What changed that was a person came to me, knocked at my door, and he says, "Dr. Sharma, I have read your paper, and I'm going to commercialize your technology." That's the start of Embrex.
Embrex was based on the Sharma patent. Taking that from the laboratory to the commercial poultry industry was our challenge. We had this huge device, big machine is what we called it, and it could run about 20,000 eggs an hour. We would have issues immediately. We would have a device that we thought was ready, and we go to the hatchery, and we brought all our supplies. We brought 6 or 8, 10 people. We get everybody there, and we put the first eggs on the device, and it breaks. Stop. You know, we make adjustments. We try again. The scope was learn everything we could about the immunology and the physiology of delivery of vaccine. We made probably 4 or 5 iterations of it, simplifying it. The efficacy of the vaccination was better. There's tremendous labor savings. What it has enabled is that we can go from the hatching compartment to the farm in as little as 2 to 4 hours.
Inoval vaccination technology is a proposition that seems to be attractive, but it's intimidating. That's where the customer service makes the difference.
One of the biggest fears was hatch loss. You're gonna be punching a hole in the egg and how they're still gonna hatch. We ran them for trials and we didn't see any loss.
It was about 1990 when we started, when we put the machine in. You know, it was an easier process through the hatchery. The cleanup at the end of the day was much easier.
What used to take us about an 8-hour day, we can run in about 4 or 4.5 hours now.
The cost savings was the big benefit.
From the supplier, we become partner because we are now providing them with solutions.
We started our global expansion. Italy, Spain, UK, South Africa, Middle East, Israel, Peru, Argentina, Brazil.
There was a cascade.
The industry started embracing the technology.
We were the first ones in Colombia. The early protection was one of the most important goals of the Inova vaccination. To be able to give a high quality day-old chick is rewarding, I think that Inovo is a must.
Zoetis has always been very proactive on their repair and technology. They've done a very good job staying ahead of the game.
We've actually accelerated a lot of our vaccine development to really provide a great solution to our customers. The fact that we've moved towards vectors that can protect against multiple diseases is one of the big evolutions.
Zoetis, and when it was Embrex, has been a great company to work with, performed a lot of duties for us without ever failing.
It's a major breakthrough, not only for poultry, it's a major breakthrough for science.
To put it in perspective, every day, we're injecting, on the average, over 50 million eggs, 20 billion eggs a year. We're helping supply that and making it more efficient.
I think the world's a better place. We're trying to put food on the table for all Americans and even people across the seas.
Trying to make the poultry cheaper, it's been a goal of all of us.
Biggest thing that I'm proud of is feeding millions and millions of people all around the world.